This XP Pen display tablet is so cool, it made me an artist overnight. I mean, look at this cat. The Artist 16 Gen 2 display is quite new and is the superior version of the Artist 12. It also comes with the X3 Pen, which is a big deal and I'll explain later. But the tablet has enhanced color display. An extra port, 10 keys for better control, and most importantly, it is 15.5 inches diagonally in size. That's a 25% increase in size. There's just so much more control on this thing. I was always suspicious about display tablets. I thought it was just much easier to use pencils and papers. Boy oh boy was I wrong. Not only was this tablet easy to set up, but it kept surprising me the more I used it. In this video, I will quickly show you how it felt drawing on this tablet live. I'll tell you everything that I found awesome about it, and how it made me and can make you draw perfect art better than ever before. If you end up wanting this tablet, you can find it in the description below. It might be a little pricey, but I found it totally worth it. Being simple is one of its key features, making it perfect for beginners who are trying to learn how to use digital art, or are looking to improve their skills, as well as any experienced users looking to get a better edge and improved sensitivity. To understand why the XP tablets are so famous, the first thing we have to do is check what comes inside the box. Better than any unboxing I have done before, this tablet came with everything needed and more. Nice rhyme. So yeah, that's why I give it a perfect score. Ooh, triple rhyme.
Look at this, everything is packed really neatly. The tablet has two protection layers. You get four adapters, compatible for pretty much any country you are in or are going to go to.
There's also a warranty card and a very clear instruction manual.
Of course, it comes with the X3 pen, which is an enhanced pen capable of scary stuff.
The coolest thing that comes with it are the cables.
Everything you need is there, even extension cables, all neatly packed.
After taking the tablet out, I now had a lot of expectations to be met.
So I quickly connected it to my PC, downloaded the software,
which by the way I will include in the links below. Then I started testing.
All you have to do is turn it on, open the software, specify where the edges are, and you're good to go.
I use Affinity Photo as my go-to digital design software,
which is a little unusual, yet this tablet instantly connected and was ready to go.
It's so nice not to have to mess around with configurations. And yes, it's also compatible with almost all art software and operating systems.
First of all, let's test the pen accuracy. How easy is it to follow and trace over something? Since this pen is 10 times more sensitive with 8,200 sensitivity levels and starts drawing at pressures as little as 3 grams even at a 60 degree tilt, the X3 pen is very impressive. It's also made more durable. In the first test, drawing the lines felt as smooth as butter and felt much more realistic, probably because the tip doesn't retract as much as other pens. The second test was to see how clear the sensitivity levels were.
And I was astonished to find out that you can do quite a lot with this sensitivity.
You can go from small to big, light to dark, both at the same time, and you can even control the minimum and maximum levels. Actually, it's capable of a lot more, but these features are the most important. So yeah, it registers very clean input and doesn't miss information at all.
Putting it to the true test, I decided to draw something really difficult, something like this cat. Even though I'm not really good at drawing, the only cheating I did was tracing the cat's main features. And then it was time to go. The drawing overall took me around 6 hours, which is a little bit faster than it would have taken if I had used a normal pen and paper.
I quickly went to the tablet software and fixed the hotkeys to how I like it, and started with the eyes. Even when zoomed in a lot, and in small pixels, the tablet responded very accurately. So after watching a couple of drawing videos, I finished the eyes, and then it got really interesting. The nose is quite harder than you would expect, a lot of different shades and angles.
But what was really hard was the fur everywhere.
At this point, I was smashing away at the tablet, and this would continue for hours and hours.
I realized that I wasn't using the hotkeys as much as I thought.
I guess being used to the keyboard hotkeys made my work a little slower, but I was steadily moving forward.
I can definitely say that the durability on this thing is well deserved. By the way, subscribe to this channel if you are interested in staying updated with the newest art technologies and gadgets. And throw a like if you're enjoying this video.
With a little fur here and a little more there, it was time to start smudging, my favorite moment. Things start to look more natural now.
And next, more fur.
If you haven't noticed, I'm a lefty. However, there's an option to flip the tablet around. I just didn't use it. I'm comfortable having a pen in one hand and a mouse in the other.
The hand glove wasn't necessary either.
I am resting my palm on the screen, and it is not detecting it.
That is probably one of the highlights of this tablet. My previous tablets had more problems detecting the pen.
Things are starting to look quite good at this point. There's not much left to do. A little color grading and a quick background. And voila, not bad, not bad at all.
My final thoughts about this tablet are, it's quite a nice tablet. I'm going to start doing a little more art now. Things are getting interesting. I have summarized all the pros and cons here for the tablet. And since you're still here, I thank you for watching the video.